In today's class, we are going to start with a new chapter, that is your unit 2, polynomials. Now guys, polynomials is there in class 8, polynomials is there in class 9, and polynomials is also there in class 10. In class 8, I hope some of your concepts have already been clear, but since you are going to start a new phase, I'm going to start from the basics. Okay? So what is polynomial? Polynomial refers to many terms. So such expressions which contains one or many terms in it is called polynomial. Now this thing might be confusing for you. What is the meaning of terms? What is the meaning of expression? Don't worry about it. I'm going to clear it for you right now. So where I'm going to start right now is from the basics. There are two words, variables, constants. These two words are the founding stone of any expression. What is the meaning of variable? Variable means those values which can be changed. Okay? Those values which can be changed or which can be altered are called variables. In an expression or in an equation, any x, y, z terms that we take are known as variables, because for example in your previous classes you might have solved linear equation in two variables where you will draw a graph. So x plus 2y equals to 7, just an example. So in this expression, what I'm going to do while making the graph is I'm going to substitute the value of x, or I'm going to substitute the value of y. Okay, that means these two variables, these two values can be changed, hence x and y are known as variables. Okay guys, whose values can be changed. The next term is your constants. What is the meaning of constant? Constant means whose values cannot be changed or altered. For example, in class KG or class 1, you have learned that 1 is represented by this symbol. But does it change in your lifetime? Will the value of 1 change? No. So 1 is a constant whose values cannot be changed. Got it? So in the same equation, if I have to make up which are the constants here, 2 and 7 are the constants present here because these values cannot be changed. Once it has been written 2, you cannot rub it off and cut 3 in it. No, that will be wrong. Okay guys? Next word term comes, the word terms. Now guys, what do you understand by term? Terms are nothing but a combination of a variable and a constant. This is called term. For example, 9x squared plus 6x plus 5 equals to 0. This is an expression, this is an equation. Now, if I ask you, what are the variables here? The variable here is x. Here also there is x, here also there is x. Okay? What are the terms here? As I have already told you, terms are combined of a variable and a constant. So in this case, this is a term. This is a term. This is a term. So there are three terms here. Okay? The first term, what is the constant? 9 is the constant, x is the variable. In the second term, 6 is the constant and x is the variable. And in the last term, 5 is the constant. Can you see any variable there? No, right? But it does exist. What is the variable here? X to the power 0. Now you have already learned in your previous classes that any number to the power 0 is 1. So x to the power 0 is 1. 5 into 1, 5. It becomes same again. Okay guys? Polynomials can be divided into three parts. Can be of more parts also, but these are the three basic parts based on their number of terms. If number of term is 1, we call it monomial. For example, 7x, this is a monomial because it contains only one term. If the number of terms is 2, we call it binomial. For example, 7x plus 3. Got it? If the number of terms are 3, we call it trinomial. 6x squared plus 3x plus 4. There are 3 terms present here. There are 2 terms present here and there are 1 terms present here. This topic has already been covered in class 8. So I'm not going deep into this, okay? Degree of a polynomial. I will just give you a simple expression. 6x to the power 5 plus 6x to the power 6 plus 2x to the power of 2 plus x. Just a simple equation, okay? Now in this equation, can you tell me what is the highest power of x? Because x is the variable here. Power is there only on top of the variable. What is the highest power of x here? Let's see. In the first term, x to the power 5. So 5 is the power. Second term, x to the power 6. Third term, x to the power 2. Fourth term, x to the power 1. So what is the highest power here? 6 is the highest power. So always remember, what do you mean by degree of a polynomial? The highest power of any variable in an equation is called degree of a polynomial. So in this equation, what is the highest power? 6 is the highest power. Hence, degree of the polynomial is 6. Is it okay, guys? Theek hai? Now, based on the degree of the polynomial, polynomials can again be divided into 3 parts. Based on the degree of the polynomial, polynomials can be divided into 3 parts. What are those? Linear, quadratic, cubic. These are the 3 types of polynomial based on their power or degree. Linear polynomial example, 7x plus 5. Quadratic, 2x squared plus 6x plus 4. Cubic, 6x cubed plus 7x squared plus 5x plus 4. This is a cubic polynomial. In this, the highest power of x is 1. In this equation, the highest power of x is 2. In this equation, the highest power of x is 3. Hence, they are differentiated as linear, quadratic, and cubic polynomial. I hope your concept has been clear. One last concept is here. That is called coefficient. Coefficient. What is the meaning of the word coefficient? The constant that lies on in front of a variable is called coefficient. For example, 7x cubed plus 6x squared plus 5x plus 10. Here, what is the coefficient of x cubed? Which number is there in front of x cubed? 7. So 7 is the coefficient of x cubed. Next term, what is the coefficient of x squared? 6. Next term, what is the coefficient of x? 5. Okay guys, am I clear? See, with this few basic knowledge, exercise 2.1 will be just extremely easy for you. Okay, so see, since we are doing online classes, I cannot go through all the questions, but I will try to cover up as many questions as I can. Okay, so let's jump into the exercise directly. We have learned all the basics that are to be needed for doing this exercise. Exercise 2.1, question number 1. I don't think I have to write down the question here, right? You can check the question paper from the textbooks. So the first question says is that, which of the following expressions are polynomials in one variable? So in this question, they have given you around 5 or 6 questions. They have given some expressions and they are asking you, out of those 5, 6 questions, which of them are polynomial in one variable? So what do we know about polynomial in one variable? Polynomial in one variable means it should have only one term in it, one variable term in it. For example, if an equation is made up of x, it should be x only. If an equation is made up of y, it should be y only. Then only we can say that those are polynomials of one variable. If more than one variable comes up, we call it equation in 2 variable or equation in 3 variable. So let's see the first question. 4x squared minus 3x minus 7. So in this question, how many variables are here, guys? I'm not asking about terms. I'm asking only about variables. How many variables are here? There are only one variable, that is x. There are 2 terms, obviously, but variable is same. That is only x variable is here. That's why this is an equation of one variable. Okay, guys? Can we go to the fifth question? The fifth question says x to the power 10 plus y cube plus t to the power 50. Now, guys, how many terms are here? Three terms. How many variables are here? Three variables. Okay? What are the variables present here? X, y, t. Is it okay, guys? Understood? The concept is clear? Okay. Thank you so much. Let's go to question number 2. What does the question say? Write the coefficient. Now, I have already explained you what are coefficients. Coefficients are those numbers which are placed in front of a variable. So, in this, you have to write down the coefficients of certain expressions. The first question is 2 plus x squared plus x. Now, guys, I'm going to give you one trick. First thing, which will be needed in any of your higher classes also. The trick is that whenever you're writing any expression, the expression should always be in the descending order in terms of their power. That means highest power should come first, then lowest, low, it goes low and low. Okay? So this is kind of jumbled up equation. So what I'm going to do at first is, I'm going to rewrite the equation in a proper form. Is it okay, guys? X to the power 2, x to the power 1, nothing is written means x to the power 0. So it is in descending order. Okay? You have to write down the coefficients of this. So how am I going to write? How many terms are there? Three terms. Since the last term does not have a variable, I'm not going to need the coefficient. So I'll write like this: coefficient of x squared is 1. See, in front of x squared, no numbers has been written. If no numbers has been written in front of a variable, we will take it as 1. Coefficient of x is 1. As you can see, in front of x also there are no numbers written, hence we are taking it as 1. Okay? So this is your answer for your question number 2, part 1. Let's go to question number 3. Pi by 2 x squared plus x. How many terms are there? 2. When you look at the equation, is it in proper form? Yes, it is in proper form because the power of the variables are in decreasing order. So it is in exactly correct form which we need. Let's see. Coefficient of x squared is what? Pi by 2 given in the coefficient. See, in front of x squared, pi by 2. Pi by 2 is a number, it's a constant. Coefficient of x. In the next question, which we have already learned before, you have to write down the degree of the polynomial. You remember what is the meaning of degree? Degree resembles the highest power. So you have to write down the degree of the polynomial. This is question number 3. I'll do question number 1. 5x cubed plus 4x squared plus 7x. This is the expression given in the question. You have to find out what is the degree of the polynomial. What is the power of x in the first term? 3. What is the power of x in the second term? 2. What is the power of x in the last term? 1. So which is the highest power? 3. So what is the degree of this polynomial? 3. So degree is 3. Is it okay, guys? Very, very simple question. Okay? Let's jump to the last question. The last question says that you have to classify the equations in terms of their degree. That means either linear or quadratic or cubic. So you just have to see the highest power there, you can differentiate easily, okay? So let's start with question number 1. X squared plus x, guys. What is the highest power here? 2. If 2 is the power, degree is 2. If degree is 2, it is called quadratic equation. Let's go to question number 3. X minus x cube. So what did I tell you? Always write down in descending order. Minus x cube plus x. Now tell me, what is the highest power here? 3. So degree is 3. That means it is what kind of polynomial? Cubic polynomial. Okay? The last question, 1 plus x. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to rearrange the equation x plus 1. So in this equation, what is the highest power possessed by any variable? X has the highest power of 1, so this is an example of linear polynomial. I hope your first exercise is clear to you. So let's proceed to the next exercise now by understanding some basic concepts. Let's start with exercise 2.4. In exercise 2.4, we are going to find out whether a certain polynomial is a factor of the other polynomial or not. We have already done one question in your previous exercise. Let's continue with that, okay? Exercise 2.4, we will jump directly to the questions because see guys, in this chapter, there is a topic called factor theorem which has been omitted by the CBSE right now. So we will not go deep into the factor theorem. We'll touch the topic a bit, then we'll move forward with the next questions. Exercise 2.4, question number 1. Determine which of the following polynomials has x plus 1 as a factor. So in this question, there are 4 sets of polynomials given. You have to show which one of these 4 polynomials is a factor, has x plus 1 as a factor. So I'll show you, I'll do 2 questions from here. You can understand by that. So this is exercise 2.4, question number 1. The px given is x cubed plus x squared plus x plus 1. Do you remember the reminder theorem in the previous exercise? We'll follow exactly the same pattern. The gx value given here is x plus 1. So what will I do now first? Equate x plus 1 as 0. Then x will be minus 1. Put the value of minus 1 here. P of minus 1 equals to minus 1 cubed. I have already told you this before. Please understand the use of bracket. Use it wisely. Use it carefully. Any questions will be easy for you. If you solve it, you are getting the answer as 0. So hence, x plus 1 is a factor of this. So you can write down in the bottom. Hence, x plus 1 is a factor. Are you guys clear with this question? Let's proceed to the next one. I will do question number 3 from the same question. Let's try to solve it. This is px. What was gx in the question? Gx was common, x plus 1. So take gx as 0. X plus 1 will be 0. Then x will be minus 1. Is it okay, guys? Put this value of minus 1 here. P of minus 1 will be minus 1 to the power 4 plus 3 to the power minus 1 cubed plus 3 to the power minus 1 square plus minus 1 plus 1. This becomes minus 1 to the power 4 is plus 1, minus 1 cube is minus 1 into 3 minus 3 plus 3 minus 1 plus 1. Okay, I can cut this. The answer is coming 1. Since the answer is not 0, you will write down no. X plus 1 is not a factor. Is it okay, guys? Very simple question. Let's go to the next question. Question number 2 is based on factor theorem, so we will not touch this question. But if you want to attempt the question, read the question. Use the factor theorem to determine whether gx is a factor of px. You will follow the exact same trend. Take gx as 0, find the value of x, put it in px. You'll get the answer. Okay? Question number 3, please stick there. Very, very important type of question. After class 10, if you are giving some competitive exam for boards like NERIST, these kind of questions are very, very important. Okay? Very standard question. Question number 3. Find the value of k if x minus 1 is a factor of px. They have already stated the fact that x minus 1 is a factor of px. Okay? So let's see how to do this kind of question. Plus x plus k. Sorry, it's k, not 1. And gx value is given. X plus 1. Oh, sorry, x minus 1. They have already said that x minus 1 is a factor. So if x minus 1 is a factor, you write down like this. If x minus 1 is a factor, then x minus 1 equate it to 0, x will become plus 1. Okay? What does this mean? If the value of x is 1 for both the equations, the entire answer will become 0. So put P of 1 as 1 square plus 1 plus k equals to 0. In place of x, I'm substituting it with 1. 1 plus 1, 2 plus k equals to 0. K will be minus 2. This is the value of k. Guys, look at the trend. Look at the process. How am I doing it? First, what I'm doing? I'm equating gx as 0. From there, I'm finding the value of x. Just like the remainder theorem, put it in px. Find the value of k by equating px as 0. Okay? I'll do one more question so that it is more clear for you. What should I do? Question number 3 or 4? I think I'll go with question number 3. Px value is given. Kx square minus root over 2x plus 1. From the previous, if I find out the value of gx, what is gx? X plus x minus 1. So if gx is x minus 1, what is the value of x? Plus 1. Put it in px. P of 1 will be k into 1 square minus root over 2 into 1 plus 1 equals to 0. K minus root over 2 plus 1 equals to 0. So k will be 1 minus root 2. I'm taking from LHS, I'm bringing it to RHS because I'm finding the value of k. 1 minus root 2, the value of root 2 is 1.141. So if you want to solve it, you can solve it. You can leave the answer like this also. There's no problem in that. Okay? Okay. Now, question number 2 is over. Let's go to question number 4. Question number 4 is based on a method called middle term factorization. Guys, middle term factorization is one of the most important methods of solving a question or solving a quadratic equation. And I guess you are familiar with that. So I'm not going to go deep into the steps on how to do it. But I'm going to solve some of the questions from here. Let me see. Question number 4. Let me do the first question. 12x squared minus 7x plus 1. Guys, see, middle term factorization is so easy. If you know how to, like, if you have enough practice of solving the question, you can directly tell what will be the roots. I can see here that 7 can be divided into 3 into 3 and 4. How did I get it? Okay, the trick here is A, B, C. What is A here? 12. What is B here? 7. What is C here? 1. First step is you will multiply A and C. When I multiply A and C, I get 12 into 1. What is A into C? 12 into 1, that is 12. Next step, this is step 1. Step 2, find the prime factorization of the value of AC. The value of A into C is 12. Find the prime factorization of 12. I will get 2 into 2 into 3. This is step 2. Step 3, group up these factors in two parts. Okay, group up these factors in two parts. No matter how many factors you get, you will always group up in two parts. So in this case, I'm going to take 4 and 3. 2 into 2, 4 and 3. How do I have to group up? I have to group up in such a way so that their addition or subtraction is equal to B. What is B here? 7. How can I get 7 out of 2 into 2 into 3? I will take 4 and 3. 4 plus 3 is 7. Okay? Very simple now, open up the brackets. Do you think the answer is done? No, the answer is not done. What I will do next, I'm going to find the values of x. So if 4x minus 1 equals to 0, x will be 1 by 4. Or if 3x minus 1 equals to 0, x will be 1 by 3. So there are two values of x here. One is 1 by 4, one is 1 by 3. How did I get it? Using middle term factorization. I'm going to do one more question, guys. Please copy it down. I cannot stress on this thing more anymore. You have to do all the questions in your copy. Please attempt all the questions in your copy. Unless you attempt mathematics, it will never be easy for you. Everyone says maths is tough. Why? Because they don't practice enough. Okay, guys? Let me do question number 3. The question number third is 6x square plus 5x minus 6. I have to factorize this. Now what is a here? 6. What is b here? 5. What is c here? 6. What was step 1? You will multiply a and c. What is 6 into 6? Step 1 is a into c. That is 6 into 6 is how much? 36. Step 2. Find out the prime factorization of 36. What will I get? 2 into 2 into 3. 2 to the 4 into 3. Will I get like this? Okay. Next step. What am I supposed to do? I have to group up these 4 factors in 2 numbers so that it becomes b. 2 into 2. If I take 2 into 2 as 1 and 3 into 3 as 1, can I get the answer? Yes. 3 threes are 9. 2 twos are 4. 9 minus 4 is b. That is 5. So step 3. 6x square plus 9 minus 4x minus 6 equals to 0. 6x square plus 9x minus 4x minus 6 equals to 0. 3x I can take common. 2x plus 3 minus 2 I can take common. 2x plus 3 equals to 0. I get bracket part on one side, the outer side part on one side equals to 0. Just like the previous question, if 2x plus 3 equals to 0, then x will be minus 3 by 2. This is the first answer. Or if 3x minus 2 equals to 0, then x will be 2 by 3, guys. Am I clear? This is middle term factorization. This is how you have to factorize the answer. There are 2 values of x given here, okay? Question number 5 is based on your factor theorem, so don't touch it. Let's go to your last exercise, which are based on algebraic identities. Some of these algebraic identities you have already learned in class 7. A plus b whole square, a minus b whole square, a plus b whole cube, a minus b whole cube. These are basic things. Here also you are going to use that only. In place of using a and b, I'm going to write the letters x and y. So please write down the identities. X plus y whole square equals to x square plus y square plus 2xy. This is the first identity. X minus y whole square equals to x square plus y square minus 2xy. X plus y whole cube equals to x cube plus y cube plus 3xy, x plus y. X minus y whole cube equals to x cube minus y cube minus 3xy, x plus y, minus 1. Okay? X plus a, this is new now. X plus a, x plus b, where a and b are numbers, x is x variable, equals to x square plus a plus bx plus ab. Okay? X plus y plus z whole square equals to x square plus y square plus z square plus 2xy plus 2yz plus 2zx. Please note that this is very, very important. This equation, these two identities are very, very important. Okay? All these identities are given in page number 44 and page number 46 and page number 47. Please go through these identities. Okay guys, let's see what is the use of these identities. We will jump directly to exercise 2.5. So the first question here, let's go, okay? The first question here, use suitable identities to find the following products. Very simple question, guys. Question number 1, part 1. X plus 4, x plus 10. You have to use the identities to do this. So how am I going to do? Is this in the form of x plus a, x plus b? Yes or no, guys? See, x, a, b. So if it is in the form of this, we will open up in the following identity. X square plus a plus bx plus ab. So just put it here. What will I get? X square plus, what is a here? 4. What is b here? 10. Plus 4 into 10. So this becomes x square plus 14x plus 40. See guys, it's a very simple question. You can easily solve all these questions, okay guys? So now for the remaining questions, I'll do it in the next class. Please practice all the questions in the previous exercise and please study well, okay guys? Thank you.